Hello everyone, welcome to Part B, Lost Common Study. Let's open the file. You can see today we are learning about how to use Lost Common to make skyscraper or towers. First one, we are learning the turning torso designed by Santiago Calatrava. And you can see this building has 5 sides polygon 4 ply. So, let's go to the Rhino file. You can open from the file that I gave you before. And so we draw a polygon first. Okay, select the polygon and the number of it is 5. If yours one is 6, 7, click here and press 5. And we just find the start point here. We input 0.0.0 and press enter. Okay, so we get a base curve here. Okay, make it a little bit bigger. And you can see I have already drawn some height reference lines and you can use it. We use copy command and use the height reference here and copy them. Okay, press enter. The tower here is twisted, right? So we twist each floor. Okay, open your gumballs here and when you click the line, it will show you a gumball. And we click the blue one, we twist it 45 degrees, again 90 degrees, again 135 degrees, and 180. Okay. And then we use loft, we use automatic in this project. Price and normal, yes, and okay. You can see the form is already made here. It's beautiful. And let's do the second one. The absolute word designed by Matt in Canada, a Chinese architect. Okay, let's say. It's a very beautiful tower. Let's go to the file and I have already drawn all lines for you. We just use the ellipses and draw it like this. Okay, you draw each floor, repeat the same work I did. Okay, so we just use the loft command again. Loft. We use natural for this one. And press enter. Normal. Yep. Do not simplify. Okay. So we get this one. But what I want to teach you for this is another command. Record history. Okay, we click record history and then we repeat the same works. Locked. Natural. Press enter. Yeah, okay. The same one, but you will see the difference. If you click a curve here, you can edit what you want. You can make it a little bit wider, thinner, or taller. But for the previous one, you say, for this one, oh, I didn't drag the lines to there, but I can show you in this one. If you drag the lines, the surface doesn't change, right? Because we didn't click the record history when we try to build this model. So please remember, if you wanna edit later for your model, you must click record history. I'm really strong suggest you do this. because you can edit what you want later. But be careful. If we drag the model to another place, it will show you dragging broke history on one object. What it means? It means if you click OK, click the line here, drag the line, the surface doesn't change anymore. So when you do record history comment, please remember you need to set your position first. If you lose your position, the record history comment doesn't work anymore. Okay, let's do the third one. Candles Tower in Dubai. Very beautiful one. But this one is a concept model. It's not a real tower. I have already drawn all of them, but it's a little bit harder to draw it. You can try if you want. Okay, let's do the same thing. Loft. Okay, there's something happened in the end point. How could we fix it? We just put a point here and drag it higher. Okay, let's try again. Use loft comment. Natural. Okay, so we get a beautiful tower. The next example is designed by Zaha Hadid, Soho. Have you heard this one before? We have new things to teach you now. Loft and click the lines. Okay, you get it, right? We are very easy, but delete this one. Let me show you what is difference if I click the other place, what it means. Okay, click here, click here, and click here. You will say the surface is not good. There is a broke surface, right? Broken surface. It means the loft comment has sequencing. I'm really strong suggest to you when you use the loft comment, you need to select them one by one. And also same part. For this model, we clicked all the left part or all the right part. Okay, let's say that's a good one. Or we can use loose. Normal is better. Okay. If you click like loft, the bottom one, the second one is bottom one, and the top one, what will happen? Let's see. It's another shape. So you will have many options you want to choose, but do the best one. The first one, second one, and third one. Click all the left side or the right side. Don't click the middle part because you don't know the middle part belongs to the left side or the right side. Okay, this is the end of this tutorial. Thank you.